that we responded really well to imagery of landscapes, because it was such a rich way of creating movement, not just physically, but people responded emotionally. You know, I had done lots of photocopies of beautiful landscapes of Australia and also of other parts of the world. What was a real shift was the fact that the dancers were part of triggering the music. Someone spoke about sunrise as like freedom, and one of those moments that you want them to last forever, but they just last a moment, and that moment is gone, but you almost want to stay in that moment. One of the things that became really, really clear was that the music was going to be the weather elements and the dance would be the landscape. We didn't want to be specific to a place, we just wanted to think about landscape. And then also we worked with maps of the world and created different devices to create movement. We ask the dancers to tell us memories or stories, their ideas, their themselves as people, and imageries that they had triggered the music. That memory comes from Bernie, that section comes from Amy, thunder, but when she's, you know, flying a chopper and she saw this thunder coming and the storm coming and how she was really scared, but it was so beautiful and thrilling at the same time, and that feeling went into the music of my memory of rain, Janessa's memory of the sunrise, and that's, you know, something quite unique. All these memories, unique to 16 different people. Bernie wrote a poem about snow, and that poem became the total inspiration for Ezio.